Hello students, today we'll study a new chapter in biology, that is the circulatory system. Circulatory system, very important chapter. See, the circulatory system comprises of your heart, then your blood which flows through your heart, then the blood vessels which carry the blood to different parts of the body, okay? And what do they all do? What is the purpose of the circulatory system? Because they help in transport of the nutrients which are there in your body to each and every cell, oxygen, and carbon dioxide. So the circulatory system comprises of the heart, blood and blood vessels which circulate the blood throughout the body, and they help in transport of nutrients, oxygen, and the carbon dioxide. Okay, and the transportation here is carried out by blood as well as lymph. Now, what is lymph? Lymph is a tissue fluid. I will explain you in detail what lymph is in the latter part of the chapter. Now, let's understand the different types of fluids which are there in our body. What are the different types of fluid which are there in the body? So, the first fluid is the most common one, that is the blood. Okay, the first fluid is the blood. It is there in the hearts and in the blood vessels. Okay, now this blood is there in the heart as well as the blood vessels. Now, what are blood vessels? Which carry the blood, means your arteries, your veins, and your capillaries. Okay, what are capillaries? See, for example, if this is a vein, or let's say this is an artery, the artery is thick, so it cannot go in each and every corner of the body. So the arteries divides into thin vessels. The arteries divide into thin vessels, and these thin vessels are called as capillaries. Okay, these thin vessels are called as capillaries. Both carry blood only. Okay, and they help in circulatory system. So the first fluid is blood. The second one is the tissue fluid. Okay, now where is this tissue fluid present? See, your body is made up of different cells. Like this. Your body is made up of different cells, which has nucleus in it. The fluid which is present between these cells is called as the tissue fluid. Okay, it is also called as interstitial fluid, because it is between the cells, so it is called as interstitial fluid. Okay, and the third one is the lymph. Now, where is the lymph present? The lymph is present in the lymph vessels. The lymph vessels are located in certain parts of your body. Lymph vessels. Okay, and also lymphatic organs. I'll tell you the location of these lymph vessels and lymph organs in the latter part of the chapter. Now, let's see the diagrammatic representation of the relationship between this blood, tissue fluid, and the lymph, and how they circulate in our body in different organs. Okay, so it is easy to understand with this diagram. See, first is your lungs. Lungs are a very important part of your body, because from lungs the blood get oxygen. Okay, then your heart is important, which is the center of all circulation, your heart. And then your body, entire body. Okay, So what happens is, in your lungs, you inhale oxygen, okay? That oxygen is added to your blood. Okay, that oxygen is added to your blood from the lungs via heart. This blood goes to the entire body. See, and which blood am I talking about? This blood is the oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood, okay, it is carried by the pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein carries the oxygenated blood, okay, it carries the blood from the lungs via the heart. See, heart controls everything, so it will pass from the heart and then it will go to different parts of the body, this oxygenated blood, okay. And as I told you that this is a blood vessel, it gets divided into thin capillaries and it goes in different parts of the bodies, okay, and then again it comes back to the lungs via the heart. So what happens is, the oxygenated blood goes to different cells in your body, okay, it gives the oxygen to the cells. Samjho, ye ek cell hai, to blood aaya, theek hai, usne cell ko oxygen diya, aur cell ke paas se carbon dioxide leke, it will go ahead. Okay, so the oxygenated blood jo hai, it will go to different cells, give the oxygen and take carbon dioxide, and then that means from different cells it will take carbon dioxide, that means we call it deoxygenated blood, and via the heart it will go to the lungs. So this is your heart. So this is the deoxygenated blood. Okay, and the vein, the blood vessel which carries it is called as pulmonary artery. So क्या हुआ, lungs ने oxygen लिया blood में mix करके, और वो oxygenated blood heart के through body को दिया. Body got all the oxygen, the carbon dioxide which was present in the cells from the blood. Now the blood will take the carbon dioxide here, okay, that means deoxygenated blood which doesn't have oxygen, which has carbon dioxide, it will take that blood to the lungs. Phir jo bhi CO2 hai wo yahan se hum exhale kar denge bahar, theek hai, so again in that blood oxygen will get added and again it will go to the body. This process will continue, okay, this is how the blood circulates in our body. Okay, now from here there is another duct which is called as lymphatic duct. Okay, from where the lymph travels to different parts of the bodies. Okay, the lymph travels to different parts of the bodies from here, like this, to different organs, lymph organs. This fluid which is there in the lymphatic ducts goes to different lymph organs. Okay, so this our circulatory system. This is about the different cells, this is going to the different cells. Now see, this is a closed system. Our circulatory system is called as the closed vascular system because it is closed. You can see from here the blood is coming, then it is again going back to the lungs, from heart via heart to the lungs, body heart lungs, body heart lungs, it keeps on circulating. Okay, in some animals they have open circulatory system, okay, where the blood flows to the heart of the body tissues without any vessels. So agar ye vessels nahi hote to it is called as open circulatory system. It is not there in humans, it is there in a few insects. Okay, we as humans have closed vascular system. Okay, now heart is a very important organ here. So let's learn further about the heart. So what is the size of the heart? You can, to know the size of your heart, you can just fold your fist like this. This is the size of your heart. Okay, the size of your, it is approximately the size of your fist. Okay, so this is the size of your heart, like this. And the weight is approximately 225 to 340 grams, depending upon your age. Okay, it is located in the center of the chest cavity. Okay, in the center of your chest cavity, and it is slightly tilted onto the left. Okay, slightly to the left. Now your heart, let's say this is your heart, this heart is enclosed within a protective double layered membrane. So there is a membrane around your heart which protects your heart, which protects your heart. That membrane is called as pericardium. Very important, pericardium, a double layered membrane which protects your heart. Okay, now see, this is the pericardium. This boundary, this dark line which I am showing, is the pericardium. Okay, so between the heart and the pericardium, there is a fluid here. There is a fluid present here, fluid. That is called as the pericardial fluid. The fluid which is present is called as the pericardial fluid. Okay. Now let's see the picture of a heart, and using that picture I will explain you how blood flows in the heart. Now the heart has four chambers. The heart has four chambers. See, as we saw in this diagram, heart, there are two functions of the heart: to take blood from the lungs and give it to the body, and to take blood from the body and give it to the lungs. Do kaam hai, theek hai? Lungs se liya blood ko aur body ko diya, body se liya aur lungs ko diya, theek hai? So let's see how this works. So your blood, which is coming from the lungs, that is the oxygenated blood. The oxygenated blood. They enter the heart from a chamber which is called as auricle. Okay, and this is the left auricle. Auricle receives the blood. Okay, the auricles receive the blood. So it comes to the auricle. Okay, then from the auricle it goes to the ventricle. Now what does ventricles do? This is the left ventricle. What does the ventricle do? The ventricle will distribute the blood to different parts of the body. Okay, so the blood which is coming from the lungs comes to the left auricle. From the left auricle it goes to the left ventricle, which distributes it to the different parts of the body. Okay, now the right auricle, the right auricle also receives the blood, but it receives the blood from the body. You understand? From the body. And this blood is deoxygenated, because sara oxygen to cells ko de diya hai. Okay, so this is deoxygenated blood. Okay, this deoxygenated blood from right auricle goes to right ventricle, okay, and what will the right ventricle do? It will give this blood to the lungs for purification. Understood? And the lungs will again oxygenate it, उसमें oxygen add कर देंगे और फिर left auricle को देंगे, ठीक है? वो ventricle को देगा, ventricle will distribute it to the body, फिर body से वापस right auricle में आएगा, वहाँ से right ventricle और lungs के पास जाएगा. Then here lungs में क्या होगा? It will get oxygenated, oxygenation का process होगा यहाँ पे lungs में, ठीक है? और oxygen add हो गया, फिर वापस left ventricle को दो, left auricle से left ventricle and then to the body, body से वापस right auricle, right ventricle and lungs. This is how the process works. Okay, now in reality, with the help of the real picture of heart, we will see how this process takes place. Okay, so we will take a help of a very nice video. Now this is how your heart looks like. This left atrium here, atrium is nothing but auricle. Auricles are also called as atrium. Okay, so this is the atrium, right atrium, this is the left atrium. Okay, from the atrium it goes to left ventricles, right atrium to right ventricle. Okay, now as I told you, in this left atrium the blood will flow in. Which blood? Oxygenated blood will flow in from this left atrium. Okay, so let's see how it happens. Now before that, this is called as a tricuspid valve and this is a mitral valve. Valve means they are doors, okay, which open for the blood to go from auricle to ventricle. Okay, so from right auricle to right ventricle, it goes through tricuspid valve. This is called as a tricuspid valve. From left auricle to left ventricle, it goes through mitral valve. Okay, now from this auricle, it comes to ventricle. See, this is auricle, ventricle. From ventricle, it goes to the lungs. So lungs mein kaise jayega? Lungs mein jayega through a vein, a special vein. I'll tell you which vein. Okay, the vein is pulmonary, this pulmonary valve. You can see this part. Okay, see, blood, जो ब्लड बॉडी से आया यहाँ पे राइट ऑरिकल में, ठीक है, राइट से राइट वेंट्रिकल में आएगा और फिर यहाँ से वो इसके थ्रू बाहर जाएगा. ओके, दैट इज़ द पल्मनरी वेन. इसके थ्रू, यहाँ पे जो पल्मनरी वेल्व दिख रहा है ना, इसके थ्रू वो लंग के पास जाएगा. ओके, फिर यहाँ से जो ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड आता है वो लेफ्ट ऑरिकल से लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल में आएगा, ठीक है. एंड फ्रॉम यर, ये जो aortic valve दिख रहा है, this is called as aorta. The name of this blood vessel is aorta. So from this aorta, it will go to different parts of the body. Okay, let's see how. See how the blood flows. The heart is beating. See, the blood is coming in and it is going here. Coming in, going here. From here, the blood is coming in and it is going out from here. Can you see? Okay, see once again. Blood is coming in, going out, coming in, going out. From here it is coming in, going out. This is a pure blood and this is deoxygenated blood. Okay, this deoxygenated blood, see. First, it starts coming in the heart. The blood is coming in the heart from the pulmonary vein. It is coming in the heart from pulmonary vein. Okay, to the left atrium. Atrium means auricle. And from वहाँ से it comes to left auricle. Left auricle to left ventricle. ठीक है, pulmonary vein से left auricle, left auricle से left ventricle. Okay, from here it will go to this aorta. It is going to the aorta. And from the aorta it will go to different parts of your body. You can see. Now from here the aorta, it goes to different parts of your body. The arteries. It is going to the arteries, to different parts of your bodies via the capillaries. Okay, and now from this, once the oxygenated blood has reached your body, the deoxygenated blood will come back from the body, जो veins से आता है deoxygenated blood, okay, वो veins से आके heart के अंदर enter करेगा, ठीक है, पूरे body में से, from vena cava, the vein is called as vena cava, तो सारा deoxygenated blood आया, अब वो heart के अंदर enter करेगा, ठीक है, so see, it is entering from here, inside your heart. Deoxygenated blood enter किया, right atrium में enter किया, फिर ये valve है, ये valve open हुआ, so यहाँ से वो right ventricle में आया, okay, right ventricle में आया, and from right ventricle it goes to the lungs. How will it will go to the lungs? From this path, you can see this path through the pulmonary artery, okay, through the pulmonary artery. Let's see once again. It came inside and from the pulmonary artery, it is going to the different parts of the blood. Okay? This is a continuous process which takes place. See the flow once again. Yahan se in aya, body mein gaya. Yahan se andar aya, lungs ke paas gaya. Theek hai? This is the flow. This heart is pumping. See, they are contracting, expanding. This process continues. So we have understood how the process takes place here. That the blood comes from through the left auricle to left ventricle and then goes to the body. Okay, goes to the body from the vein called aorta. Then comes from the body to the right auricle, then to the left right ventricle and goes to the lungs from the vein which is called as pulmonary artery. Okay, now there is a valve between the right auricle and the right ventricle that is called as tricuspid valve. Okay, like a door which opens and then blood enters here. And from left auricle to left ventricle, it is a bicuspid valve. Okay, a door which opens and the blood enters here. Okay, now from left ventricle to the aorta, there is again a valve which is called as semilunar valve. Okay, and from right ventricle to lungs, there is again another semilunar valve. Okay, now why are these valves? These valves are of this shape, like this. They have a shape like this. That means the blood which enters comes from here, can go here, but it cannot return back. The blood cannot return back because they are shaped in such a way, okay, that it can open only from this side like this. It can open only from this side. Blood will come from here and it will open like this. But blood cannot enter from this side. Okay, so blood ka entry sirf ek hi taraf hota hai. Blood will always go from auricle to ventricle. It can never go back from ventricle to auricle because of these valves. The valve prevent the reverse flow of the blood. Okay. This is how your heart works. Now, your heart is made up of specialized muscles, which are called as cardiac muscles. They are called as cardiac muscles. Okay. These muscles continuously contract and relax. We have seen that in the video. How they contract, relax, okay, they contract, expand, you can say, relax means expand, so they contract and relax, okay, throughout the lifetime of a person, this contraction and relaxation is a continuous process, it never stops, okay, and who gives the impulse, see, ye rhythm jo hai, ye kabhi miss nahi hoti. तो एक इम्पल्स मिलता है हमेशा हार्ट को कि नाउ स्टार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग नाउ स्टार्ट रिलैक्सिंग नाउ स्टार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग दैट इम्पल्स ओरिजिनेट्स इन अ नोड विच इज कॉल्ड एज एस ए नोड इन द हार्ट देर इज अ एस ए नोड एस ए मीन्स इट इज कॉल्ड एज सीनो एट्रियल नोड सो ये जो राइट ऑरिकल है ना राइट ऑरिकल ईयर यहाँ पे होता है एक एस ए नोड ओके And this SA node gives the rhythm. This SA node gives the rhythm for the contraction and relaxation. Okay, so we also called this as the natural pacemaker of the heart. This is called as the natural pacemaker of the heart, because this decides the pace of the heart, the pace of the contraction and the relaxation in your body. Okay, very important. Now, sometimes if this sinoatrial node is not working properly, we can surgically in humans introduce an artificial pacemaker. Okay, the artificial pacemaker can be introduced in your body. Artificial pacemaker. अगर आपका ऐसे नोड प्रॉपरली काम नहीं कर रहा है तो वी कैन इंट्रोड्यूस एन आर्टिफिशियल पेसमेकर सर्जिकली इन योर हार्ट एंड मेक श्योर दैट रिदम दिस कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड रिलैक्शन इज नॉट डिस्टर्ब्ड. ओके, दिस वाज अबाउट द कार्डियक मसल्स. ओके, एंड द पेसमेकर. नाउ द ब्लड वेसल्स विच आर देयर इन योर बॉडी आर ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स. The blood vessels which are there in your body are of three types. Okay, we saw just now that from the heart जो blood heart से body में लेके जाता है, the vessels which carry the blood away from the heart in this direction, away from the heart, they are called as arteries. Okay, the blood vessels which carry blood from the body to the heart, from the body to the heart, are called as veins. Okay, तो veins के अंदर होता है deoxygenated blood. ठीक है, arteries के अंदर होता है oxygenated blood. Oxygenated मतलब जिसके अंदर oxygen है, deoxygenated मतलब जिसके अंदर oxygen नहीं है, जिसके अंदर carbon dioxide है. Okay, एंड फिर हमने देखा व्हाट आर कैपिलरीज. कैपिलरीज क्या होते हैं, ये जो आर्टरीज और वेन्स है दे गेट डिवाइडेड इनटू स्मॉल स्मॉल पार्ट्स. सो इफ देयर इज वन आर्टरी लाइक दिस वन आर्टरी, आर्टरीज आर थिक. ओके, इट विल डिवाइड इनटू स्मॉल स्मॉल कैपिलरीज एंड इट विल गो इन ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ योर बॉडी. ओके, नाउ दीज वर द ब्लड वेसल्स विच आर देयर इन योर बॉडी. Now inside the heart there are some blood vessels which are inside the heart. Let's learn about them, the blood vessels which are there inside the heart. Okay, so I will name them here only. So the blood vessel which brings the deoxygenated blood into the right auricle, pure body mein se jo deoxygenated blood hai right auricle mein jo entry karta hai wo kahan se karta hai, wo karta hai vena cava se. Okay, वेना कावा एक ब्लड वेसल है, इसका नाम है, जो डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड राइट ऑरिकल में लेके आता है, इट इज कॉल्ड एज वेना कावा. ओके, नाउ ये वेना कावा भी दो होते हैं, एक नीचे से और एक ऊपर से. लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी से ब्लड लाएंगे और एक अपर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी से. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड अपर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी से जो लाएंगे उसे कहते हैं सुपीरियर वेना कावा. ओके, एंड जो लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी से ला रहे हैं उसे कहते हैं इन्फीरियर वेना कावा. ओके, बॉडी लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी से ब्लड लाया और अपर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी से भी ब्लड को राइट ऑरिकल में लेके आए. ठीक है, नाउ जो लंग्स में से ब्लड लेफ्ट ऑरिकल में एंट्री करता है दैट एंट्री इज थ्रू पल्मोनरी वेन. ओके, ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड विच कम्स फ्रॉम द लंग्स टू द लेफ्ट ऑरिकल इज थ्रू द पल्मोनरी वेन. Okay, now this blood, deoxygenated blood which goes to the right ventricle to the lungs. Okay, तो ये lungs तक कौन लेके जाता है, जैसे मैंने यहाँ पे नाम बताया pulmonary artery, it is also called as pulmonary trunk, जो lungs के पास blood को लेके जाता है. ठीक है, ये यहाँ से right auricle से blood lungs के पास पहुँचा. Okay, और जो ये ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड है लेफ्ट ऑरिकल से लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल और इससे बॉडी में जाएगा, तो किसके थ्रू जाएगा बॉडी में, कौन लेके जाएगा इसको बॉडी में, इट इज एओर्टा, एओर्टा विच टेक्स इट टू द बॉडी. ठीक है. नाउ द एंटायर ईच एंड एवरी सेल इन योर बॉडी रिक्वायर्स ब्लड, रिक्वायर्स ऑक्सीजन. ओके, सो जो आपका हार्ट है, जो हार्ट के मसल्स है, दिस कार्डियक मसल्स, ओके, दे ऑल्सो रिक्वायर ऑक्सीजन. ओके, दे ऑल्सो रिक्वायर ब्लड फ्लो इन इट. तो जो हार्ट को ब्लड फ्लो देता है, हार्ट के मसल्स को जो ब्लड देता है, ठीक है, द ब्लड वेसल्स, दे आर कॉल्ड एज कोरोनरी आर्टरी एंड कोरोनरी वेन्स. जो हार्ट के मसल्स को ब्लड सप्लाई करते हैं, दे आर स्पेशल वेन्स, स्पेशल आर्टरीज, दे आर कॉल्ड एज कोरोनरी वेन्स एंड कोरोनरी आर्टरीज, विच सप्लाई ब्लड टू द वॉल्स ऑफ द हार्ट. ओके, विच सप्लाई ब्लड टू द वॉल्स ऑफ द हार्ट. सो आई होप दिस पार्ट ऑफ हार्ट इज क्लियर. वी हैव अंडरस्टूड द सर्कुलेशन ऑल्सो ऑफ हार्ट. Now, in this diagram, I had explained you about the circulation which takes place in the heart. Okay, so एक बार blood lungs से heart में आता है, body में जाएगा, फिर body से वापस heart में आता है, and then lungs में जाता है. So two times the blood enters the heart. एक बार oxygenated blood enters and then deoxygenated blood enters. That is why it is also called as double circulation. Human circulation is also called as double circulation because the blood enters the heart twice. Okay, it is also called as double circulation. The next topic is about to study in detail about the tissue fluid and the lymph fluid. Okay, so to the tissue fluid. See, when the blood flows through the capillaries, let's say this is a capillary, okay, the blood is flowing inside the capillary. Some plasma and leukocytes. See, some plasma is a component of blood, and leukocytes are also present in the blood. Some plasma and leukocytes, they leak out through the walls. Okay, these plasma and leukocytes are nothing but the tissue fluid which leak out from the capillaries. Okay, now these are important. This tissue fluid is important because the small cells which are there in the body, the small cells, they take the oxygen from this tissue fluid, because this tissue fluids, it flows from between the cells like this. Samjho, agar ye ek cell hai, theek hai, this is the nucleus. So ye tissue fluid hai, ye cell ke aas pass se flow hota hai aise, and it gives cells the required oxygen, okay, and other nutrients also. Theek hai, so जो छोटे छोटे सेल्स होते हैं बॉडी में, द कैपिलरीज ऑल्सो कैनॉट रीच देयर, सो द टिश्यू फ्लूइड रीचेज देयर एंड डज द जॉब ऑफ टेकिंग गिविंग ऑक्सीजन एंड टेकिंग कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. ओके, देन देयर इज लिम्फ. नाउ वंस दिस टिश्यू फ्लूइड इज फ्लोइंग बिटवीन द सेल्स, there are small vessels inside our body which are called as lymph vessels. Okay, this tissue fluid enters this lymph vessels, because ye sab jayenge kahan pe tissue fluid, so it enters the lymph vessels. Okay, and from this lymph vessels they reach some nodes which are called as lymph nodes. Okay, ये लिम्फ नोड में पहुंचे, लिम्फ वेसल से टिश्यू फ्लूइड फ्लो होके लिम्फ नोड में पहुंचे. ओके, नाउ दिस लिम्फ नोड विल सेंड दिस टिश्यू फ्लूइड बैक टू द आर्टरीज एंड वेन्स. ओके, सो दिस टिश्यू फ्लूइड को लेके जाने का काम कौन कर रहा है? ये लिम्फ कर रहा है. ओके, नाउ वेयर आर दिस नोड्स प्रेजेंट? दिस आर प्रेजेंट इन आवर बॉडीज. ओके, like for example the near your neck where there is this tonsils, there is a lymph node there. Okay, there are different lymph organs also in different parts of your body, lymph organs. Now this lymph which is there, this lymph, it consists of two parts. One part is the cellular part and another is the non-cellular part. Okay, cellular part means which contain all the leukocytes. Leukocytes are cells. Okay, they are also called as WBCs, white blood cells. And this non-cellular part of the lymph is nothing but the water, mostly the water which is there. Okay, and sometimes the some part, 94% is water and the remaining part is proteins, fats, carbohydrates, okay, some antibodies. All this is present in the lymph fluid. Okay, the lymph fluid has some cellular part and some non-cellular part. So the cellular part is the leukocytes and the non-cellular part is this water, largely water, and then some part of proteins, fats, carbs and antibodies. Why is this lymph required? Because the lymph gives nutrition to the body, to different cells. Okay, and it is a drainage for the tissue fluid. ये जो टिश्यू फ्लूड आ रहा है यहाँ से एक्स्ट्रा जो यहाँ पे लीक आउट हुआ और वो सेल्स के बीच में गया, ये जाएगा कहाँ पे, इसको कौन लेके जाएगा? तो इसको लेके जाएंगे लिम्फ. तो इट इज़ अ ड्रेनेज. ओके, देन इट इज़ ऑल्सो फॉर एब्जॉर्प्शन. द लिम्फ इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एब्जॉर्प्शन बिकॉज द फैट्स विच आर प्रेजेंट, ये फैट्स जो है ये हमारे इंटेस्टाइन में कौन एब्जॉर्ब करता है? लिम्फ वेसल्स के थ्रू ही एब्जॉर्ब होते हैं. ओके, जो हमारा इंटेस्टाइन है, इट टेक्स फैट्स फ्रॉम द लिम्फ एंड द लिम्फ इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म. हाउ डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म? दिस ल्यूकोसाइट्स विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द लिम्फ, दिस ल्यूकोसाइट्स आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज, इट मोस्टली हैज लिम्फोसाइट्स. ओके, दे प्रोटेक्ट द बॉडी फ्रॉम foreign viruses, bacteria. They protect the body from this virus and bacteria. Okay, they fight. They are very important. Okay, they are the defense mechanism. So lymph, inside the lymph there are nutrition also, there is drainage also taking place. It the intestine absorbs the fats from the lymph and it also gives us defense. These are the functions of the lymph. Okay, you need to study the difference between the lymph and the blood. Now, once you know what the lymph is, the next topic is the blood groups. The different blood groups. Most of you know have the basic understanding of blood groups. Karl Landsteiner in 1900. He identified different blood groups in humans. Okay, and they are differentiated on the basis of proteins which are found on the surface of RBCs. Okay, so there are different types of proteins. So there are basically two major antigens, A and B. They are named as A and B. So if on your RBCs you have A antigen, then your blood group is A. If on your RBCs you have B antigen, then your blood group is B. If you have both A and B antigen, then your blood group is AB. Okay, and if you don't have the A antigen and you do not have the B antigen also, then you have the blood group O. Okay, so there are four blood groups. If you have the A antigen, you have blood group A. If you have B antigen, the blood group is B. If you have both A and B antigen, your blood group is AB. And if you don't have A nor B, then your blood group is O. Okay? Now, the person with blood group A can donate blood. See, I'm talking about the donor. Okay, A can donate blood to A
and to AB. B can donate blood to B and AB. The person who has the blood group AB can donate blood only to AB. Okay, and the person who has blood group O can donate blood to A, B, AB and O. So means O is a universal donor. Universal donor means O can give blood to any of the other persons. Okay, and AB, if you see, can receive blood from A, it can receive from B, it can receive from AB and it can receive from O also. Means jiska AB blood group hai, wo sabse receive kar sakta hai. So AB is a universal recipient. It can receive blood from anyone. Okay, so O can give blood to anyone, AB can receive blood from anyone. Okay, but AB kisi ko de nahi sakta. AB sirf kisko de sakta hai? Sirf AB ko hi de sakta hai. Le kisi se bhi sakta hai, but de sirf AB ko sakta hai. Okay, you understand? See, this is donor. A can donate to A and AB. B can donate to B and AB. AB can donate only to AB. And O can donate to all four. Okay? And this columns will tell you kisse receive kar sakte hai. Toh O kisse receive kar sakta hai? Sirf O se. AB charo se receive kar sakta hai. B sirf B se receive kar sakta hai aur O se receive kar sakta hai. A can receive from A and from O. Okay? So this was about the blood groups, different blood groups. Very important objective questions can come from here. Now there are different blood banks. You might have heard of blood banks, the blood donation camps which takes place. Okay, and they take the blood from different donors and store them in blood bank. So when if any of a patient requires blood of any group, so you can buy that from the blood banks. Okay, now when the blood is kept in the blood bank, why the blood is kept in the blood bank? So when a person, let's say a person A requires blood, okay, of blood, let's say his blood group is A, he requires blood, so he will take the blood from the blood bank. Now before taking the blood from the blood bank, there are certain conditions, there are certain factors, there are certain important points to be noted before taking the blood. Okay, and what are they? First of all, if he is of blood group A, he will only take the blood group A. You cannot give him the blood from a person which has blood group B or AB. Okay, so same blood group hona chahiye. Theek hai? Same blood group, or it should be compatible. Compatible means, see, A can receive blood from A or it can receive blood from O also. Theek hai? To A ko ya to A se do ya to O se, because O can give to anyone. Okay. अगर ये मैच नहीं हुआ, फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल अगर आपने गलती से किसी ए बी पर्सन का ब्लड ग्रुप ए को दे दिया, ठीक है, तो दिस विल लीड टू क्लंपिंग इन द बॉडी ऑफ द पर्सन एंड ही मे इवन डाई. ओके, सो यू हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट कंपैटिबिलिटी इज मेंटेन्ड वाइल ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन. ओके, कंपैटिबिलिटी शुड बी मेंटेन्ड वाइल ब्लड transfusion. Now there are certain conditions of heart. What are these conditions? Let's understand. I list down the conditions.
I have listed some extra points also here. So you understand everything properly, okay? So these are some heart related conditions. Sometimes you can say palpitation. What are palpitation? If your heart is beating too fast or too hard, okay? Like if someone scares you, okay? Or if you see something which frightens you, suddenly your heart will start palpitating, okay? Fast beating of the heart is called as palpitation, okay? Now this palpitation is not good. If it continues for a long period of time, it can even lead to chest pain. It can lead to chest pain, okay? So this palpitation is nothing but fast and hard beating of heart, okay? Then what is hypertension? Hypertension is when the blood flow is higher than normal. The blood flow is higher than normal. When we say high BP, high blood pressure, jo hum kehte hai na, high BP, it is nothing but hypertension. If you have lot of stress, if you are constantly thinking too much about something, okay, the heart flow, the blood flow to your veins, the blood vessels will increase, and this may cause high BP. It can be because of hypertension, stress, diet. If you eat something very spicy, for example, or very salty, your blood pressure may increase because the blood flow will be higher than normal. Okay. Now, what is heart attack? Heart attack is the sudden interruption of blood flow to the heart. Means the blood flow will stop for some time. Then we say that the person has suffered from a heart attack. Okay. Why can this happen? It can happen because of blood clot. आपकी अगर कोई ब्लड वेसल है और यहाँ पे अगर ब्लड क्लॉट हो गया बीच में, तो ब्लड कैन नॉट फ्लो फर्दर, ओके? तो ब्लड फ्लो इज स्टॉप्ड, इट इज इंटरप्टेड, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज हार्ट अटैक, ओके? एंड इफ द हार्ट अटैक मस्ट बी इमीडिएटली चेक्ड अपॉन और एल्स इट मे लीड टू परमानेंट डैमेज ऑफ द हार्ट, ओके? सो अगर ये ब्लड क्लॉट समझो 90% क्लॉट हो गया, मीन्स ओनली 10% ब्लड इज अलाउड टू फ्लो, ओके? सो सडनली इट नीड्स अ सर्जरी, इट नीड्स चेकिंग, ओके? एंड बाय सम मीन्स दिस क्लॉट इज रिमूव्ड एंड द ब्लड फ्लो इज इंक्रीज्ड, ओके? व्हाट कैन हैपन, यू मे हैव वेरी टाइटनेस इन योर चेस्ट, यू मे फील पेन, ओके? योर शोल्डर्स, टीथ, जॉज, आर्म्स, ऑल विल स्टार्ट पेनिंग. Then your breath will be reduced, you will feel sweaty. All these are the consequences of a heart attack, okay? See, understand, heart attack ka matlab kya tha? Ki blood flow will stop for some time to the heart. Heart ko blood nahi mil raha hai, theek hai? Heart ko blood nahi mil raha hai, so it is heart attack, okay? What is cardiac arrest? Cardiac arrest means the blood flow to the body is interrupted, is stopped. Body ko blood flow nahi mila agar, theek hai? When a heart suddenly stops pumping blood around the body, then it is said that it is cardiac arrest. Okay, body ke cells ko blood milega hi nahi. Blood nahi mila agar body ko, to oxygen nahi milega. Oxygen nahi milega, to suddenly the person will feel unconscious. Okay, and it may lead to shortness of breath, nausea. Okay. And if it sustains for a long time, the person may even die. Okay, so you should understand the difference. Heart attack means blood flow to the heart is interrupted, and cardiac arrest means blood flow to the body is interrupted. Okay, so this difference is very important. Now, one thing you might hear is about stroke. What is a stroke? So stroke is nothing that stroke is a serious condition that occurs when blood supply to the brain is cut off. Matlab brain ko blood nahi mil raha hai. No blood to brain.
then we call it as a stroke. The person suffered from a stroke. This is something extra for you. Okay, no blood to the brain, it is called as stroke.
Okay, now you should always try to keep your heart healthy. Okay, what should you do for that? You should exercise regularly. Okay, you should eat good food. You should avoid oily and fried foods, nutrient-rich foods, fresh vegetables, fruit juices. You should avoid eating too much. You should avoid gaining too much weight. You should play outdoor games, jogging, cycling, walking, swimming to stay healthy. If you do all of that, then you will never face these problems in your life. Okay? This is all about the circulatory system in your body. To understand any concept better, you can rewind the video and watch it again. That's it for today. Thank you.